So a simple income statement. I can use automation. Again, here I'm automating at the subsidiary level. Here I can use automation to, for example, push different department codes through or location codes through. And what I'm doing here is I'm actually taking the worksheets that are being generated. I'm outputting them into a workbook name called Consolidated. And you can see here that you can associate an email address with that set of data. So if I were to run automation in this scenario, it will go down each of the different department codes or budget codes or location codes, dropping them into the worksheet, generating different versions, and then outputting them or emailing them automatically. If you want to run your management accounts out to email, make sure you set up the email address on the automation sheet. And then when you go to the automation menu, you go to the email option instead of the save option, choose the sheet that you want to output. And there you can see, you can also change the sheet name that you want to push out. And there's our token again being used to rename the sheets as they go out the door. When you send out an email, you also get the ability to put a nice email message in. You can also embed tokens into the email message so that Solution 7 will swap those tokens out with whatever's defined on the automation sheet. I'll show you a couple of other nice features in here. When you do push your workbooks out via automation, this is probably the bit I want to show you. You've got the ability to drop and lock formulas. So when you're pushing out management accounts, for example, your end users may not have a license to use Solution 7. So in that scenario, you'll either want to drop or lock the formulas. If you drop the formulas, as we build the output sheets, we actually take the formulas and throw them away. So they just turn into static values. If you lock the formulas, we actually re-encode the formula in such a way where we fool Excel into not seeing the formula part of the cell. Again, both of these options are designed so that your end users don't need a licensed copy of NetSuite. They don't need Solution 7. They don't even really need Excel. As long as they can open and edit a workbook, the whatever spreadsheet editor they're using, Google Sheets, Excel Online, whatever, it won't see our formulas. So they can just edit those spreadsheets as if they were regular workbooks. So that's the first scenario, automating management. Second scenario, automating management accounts. The third scenario, I always describe as, have you ever been tempted to build a master template by department, for example, and then copy paste, and then change the department code and change the department code and change the department code. So you end up with, you know, 5-10 workbooks that look identical, each for different departments. The downside of doing that is if you ever need to change the shape of those workbooks, you need to edit every single department workbook that you've created. You could have 5 and it's relatively easy. You could have 50 and it becomes a real horrendous job. Automation will build those workbooks for you. So I always recommend build a master template that's in the shape that you want, or it's in a shape that can be easily maintained. Generate an automation sheet with all of the different scenarios in it, locations, departments, whatever. Run the automation process. That will build out all those individual sheets for you. If you ever then need to change those sheets, don't go through and update them all individually. Do you know what? Just throw them away. Go back to the master template, rerun, change the template how you want it, rerun the automation, and then we'll do all that heavy lifting for you. Again, the whole point of Solution 7 is we're trying to do all the heavy lifting so you don't have to. Just trying to keep your lives as simple as possible.